Who is you? Hey boy, hey girl. Ah. Childhood memories and recipes and things like that. I made this one before. I don't think I ever put it on video though. I'm gonna do Big Boys spaghetti and meat sauce. On Sundays we used to go out when Big Boys restaurant, which was later formed into Shoney's and Fritch's, and there's many different franchises that branched off of Big Boys, Bob's Big Boys, and I was just Googling it. That was more than I wanted to fool with. Anyway, I used to love their Big Boy burger, kind of like a how you call it? What's that Mickey crap? D got the one with a couple slices of meat in there. Anyway, but on steroids because it was a bigger boy burger. Now, kind of like the ones I make, huh? Anyway, I used to like this spaghetti and meat sauce, and I reconstructed it from memory, and I got it pretty close. Last time I made it, which was a couple years ago, we made it again about a month ago, and I'm gonna make it again. And last time I made it, I added some smoked sausage to it, and it made it even better. So we're gonna do that. Other childhood memory recipes. We had some of the finest cooks in the world at when I was going to high school, in junior high. And the pizza they made, they would make it by the big ass sheet pan. And I found that recipe. And the recipe that I found, sir, it makes like, shit, I forget now, but enough to feed 100 people or 250 people. So you gotta scale it down and try to get the proportions right. And I got it pretty close. I think I named the recipe high school or school pizza or something like that. And they used the mix. So I used the mix when I did that. Anyway, let's go on with this recipe. It's easy, quick, and you can use frozen Trinity in it, but I'm gonna make my own fresh. It helps it out, it gives it a little better flavor when it's fresh, whack up, like that day. So we got us a bell pepper, right? Right. Get you some of this veggie wash. Because what they got, they may have pesticides, people jizz, somebody. I sneezed on a bell pepper. Get that off of that. They also put wax on them to make them look all shiny and pretty in the grocery store. So spray this shit on there and then rinse it in the zinc, scrub it, give it a bath. I don't know if you do that, but to yourself, don't put fit on yourself no more. So after you done give it a little bath, it's all squeaky clean now, got the wax off, the snot and all other stuff. We're gonna cut it up and put it in there with the onions, the celery, and the other part of the bell pepper that I had. And we'll go from here. I'll show you what to do next. Stand by. Now use plenty of celery. The celery is real good in tomatoes. Pay attention, boy. Celery is real good in tomatoes. Sauces. Especially this one. That's what the Big Boys used to do. And I like to put a lot of bell pepper over here. A lot of bell pepper in there because bell pepper is full of vitamin C and it's sweet when you cook it down. Same way with onion. Oh, this is sweet. We got another tip. If you're going to use tomato paste in something, if you cook it down first, you auto panning, ain't you? Snug up tripod. Tomato paste. Get you a little small non-stick skillet. Put you a little piece of butter in there. Tomato paste. And cook it down, stirring constantly for 10 to 15 minutes. And that's going to release the natural sweetness from the tomato product. I'm going to take a shortcut. I'm going to use stewed tomatoes in here, which that has been done by stewing the tomato. It's like stewing a cabbage. Normally a cabbage ain't sweet. If you stew it, it becomes naturally sweet. It's a chemical reaction. I don't know. Go Google it if you can figure out how to type. It's G. You gotta find a G key first. Now the one thing I loved about the Big Boy's spaghetti sauce, meat sauce, was it was chunky. Had a lot of chunks of vegetables, big chunks, and I like chunky sauce, so that's what we can do it. I forgot to mention that, so I had to add it. Okay, pay attention, boys and girls.
Throw you some Earl in a pan. Do it have to be EVOO? I'm sure our Big Boys didn't do all that. Pour some more. Put all this vegetables in there. Play cymbals and drums on them too. You don't have to have the pan hot prior to, because we're not searing meat. We're sauteing vegetables. Pause, cut, restart. Okay. Go ahead and do put a little bit of seasoning in there. Put you some salt and pepper. It's gonna start your seasoning process. Now go put it on the stove, on a fire. Turn the fire on the stove on, get you, boy. You peel you up some garlic and get your damn meat hammer out and smash it. If you got any worms in it, they dead, you can eat them. Don't worry about all that bullshit. And I'm sure this is how the restaurant would do it. Now, we can eat that one whole. We'll save that one. Scrape your finger off too, boy. Go put that in the pot, the Losh Papa Tot. Down there. Hope y'all can see all that. I'm gonna go drink some beer. Unless I already had enough. Oh, I'm rubber. No, I ain't. Shut the exhaust fan off. Now we can start to have fun. You see all this? That's water coming out of those vegetables. And I had this covered. Now, like I said, you cut all this stuff up beforehand. Then you come simmer it in the pot. A little bit of oil, a little salt and pepper, cover it. The beans, we got liquid in that pot. That's the pot. See the pot? Put some garlic in there. You can put garlic in a dry pot, but you really got to pay attention. And I don't really feel like paying attention. Y'all all come off with a paper plate. Just put the whole damn paper plate in there. Who cares? No, you can't do that, boy. That is resurrected recipe from the days of old. I know for a fact that back then they wouldn't have used frozen Trinity because that wasn't available, nor garlic. Well, they did have garlic powder, but we went ahead with the fresh thing instead of. They would have used some parsley,
You want fresh? Use fresh. I ain't got none. Stuff they had in the store looked like crap. They would have used oregano. You want fresh? Use fresh. I bet in the original recipe, matter of fact, I know for a fact, they used dried. So, we got all that stuff in here. And what they would not have done at a restaurant is put wine in here. Well, we're going to do it anyway. Because it makes it more better. Let me get some out the fridge. So, we got us a dry red wine. And this is Cabernet Sauvignon. Not expensive wine. It comes from Oakleaf Vineyards. Thank you, Oakleaf. Let us put some of that in there. And I'm sure they would not have taken this step at the restaurante. But at a la JB restaurante, we doing that. We also got to get us some tomatoes in there. Yeah, that's the word. Got us some stewed tomatoes that's sliced. And they have a wonderful, wonderful flavor. They're sweet. We're going to bring down the temperature on the Las Papadot. And if you want to make them skeet everywhere, like my buddy Troy did, just reach in there and squeeze them. But we're going to be all right with this. We're going to let them go like that and just whack on them some. And hope they don't skeet on the camera. Let them skeet in the pot. And on a dirty stovetop. Now, y'all happy? They said they was happy. So into a waiting pan, we got some real Cajun mild hickory smoked sausage. And it's poke sausage. That's what we want to use to complement the beast. The beef. Come on, open up, non-union song, bitch. Gonna get us two drinks of this out of there. I'm only gonna use half of this drink. We're gonna keep the rest for another cook. Do that another time. So, we're gonna whack these up into little coins. If I remember to turn the knife down the right way. Little coins, and put them in a little pan of oil. And get them browned. How now? Sausages down here are so wonderful. You see all the fat inside of that? That's what makes this sausage good. You see up in there? Hunks of meat, fat sausage with yum. That's what makes Cajun sausage so good. Other major manufacturers grind this to pieces like with making gyros. They're wrong, they fail. It's the way it ought to be. And if you put green onions in that, and you see green specks in there too. Yum. Put this in the pan with the oil and go saute this down. Get them brown. That's what we're gonna do. Sausages is ready. And we're gonna put them over here in the pot with the vegetables. And I hadn't put any tomato sauce in here yet. But we're gonna. But we do want to drain that grease out of that, over here. We want to get all that grease out of there. And we got to put some grind meat in there too. So I'm going to drain the grease, put the sausage in there, and start some grind meat in the same pan. I got some 80-20 grand chuck. And I guess if you're extremely non-union, you just eat it like what's already over there. That ain't happening. We're going to put about that much. About, what is this? 3.795 pounds. So we're going to put about that much in there. That's fee-fi-fi-fo-fum pounds. Now, we'll keep the rest for hamburgers or something the next day. So like that. Go brown that down. Now I drain that grind meat that I brown, and I'm fitting to put in some day for jelly tomato juice. Look at this. It's like fresh out of the bottle. It's got a lot better flavor than that canned stuff does. This is out of a cart. See, truly Adam. Tomato juice, not from concentrate. Field to cart. Got a little bit of sea salt in it. Yum. Get that grind meat in there. Grind meat in. Stir all this in there. We have to burn us a little bit of pasta and serve this on top. Now I got some regular skinny noodles, but I got also got these little shells, and they actually hold more sauce than a straight noodle do, because it got a little pocket in there. So we're gonna make that with this, this with that. And we got some garlic bread. And we're gonna cook that. And I got another loaf too, but we're gonna make it. We're gonna cook it. And we're gonna eat it. And no, I'm not drunk. I'm standing up. Yum. Just look over here. It's the way it looks now. Seeing that? Tomato sauce. Yum. Big Bob. Look at that hunk of garlic right there. Man, that's mine. Let me get that out of there. Stand by. This is better the second day. This is day one. Miss JB made a caprese salad, which is water, mozzarella, fresh basil, tomatoes, and balsamic vinegar that she was pouring on top. And that's good stuff. She forgot to put pepper on it because she don't like it on hers. Oh well, put it on yours. Yum. A little garlic bread with some green shit. Look, it's a salad looking thing, huh? That the noodles is on day one. And then we're gonna top it with all of the other stuff. Some Dago or Italian cheeses on top. Another, oh, that looked like the money shot for the video right there. Got a pretty color on it. Maybe not. Oh, I don't know what I was doing. I snapped some pictures of hot sauce collections and look, there's my old camera. That's the other Canon that I was using. It's not HD. What are them pigs doing by my camera? Don't get no jizz on that camera, boy. It still worked. Okay, this is day two. Pot, lodge, patat. Boy, it's raining again here in South Louisiana. That day two with real spaghettis and other pretty green shit on top. Don't that looks pretty? Rosemary, oreganos, and basils, and
that stuff's good, man. I love tomato juice.